rod will, whenever you will heat the rod will experience, like a heat is entering to the rod, then rod will experience change in length. Length of the rod will increase. And this change in length, suppose del L, definitely it will increase because expansion happens. So first you understand basic idea about expansion, then only we can go ahead. Expansion is nothing but, and they have asked a question in GATE before 2-3 years. See, how will you calculate the expansion? So expansion in length because of the heat supply is happening because of three things. It depends on three things. It is proportional to how longer you were in the beginning, means what was your length in the beginning before we started heating. It depends on one more thing, how much temperature you are changing. Maybe you are heating the bar from 10 degree to 20 degree, or maybe you are heating the bar from 10 degree to 50 degree, like how much temperature you are changing. And then it depends on the final thing, the change in length depends on, that is, what kind of material it is. It is iron, it is aluminium, it is copper, it is what kind of material it is. So for that, we give alpha. Alpha is linear expansion. Okay, coefficient of linear expansion. That is known as alpha. Don't be confused with proportional sign and alpha here because of my handwriting. Okay. Now you can combine them together and you can write del L is equal to alpha L del T. Some teachers teach in this way. They teach that our change in length depends on L and it is depends on change in temperature. So they combine both equations and then they write L proportional to L into del T, and then they say that remove this sign. So they put one alpha here, L del T, and they say this is a coefficient of linear expansion. So here this was my way. Okay, now you see guys, in this del L by L, from this formula, find out del L by L, means divide both sides by L. So this L will get cancelled and here will be getting L alpha del T. Now try to understand, this is mathematical form of strain. Mathematical form, why I'm saying, I will explain now. This part is nothing but strain, correct? We know this, change in length by length gives us a strain. Okay. When you are heating the rod and if the rod is expanding by length del L, then you will be getting a strain for sure. Because strain is nothing but we are trying to figure out the, you know, deformation happened how much. So del L by L was your deformation. Okay, that is only we are saying as a strain. But what about stress? What about stress? Stress will be zero if this expansion is happening freely. Try to understand what I'm saying. Because if you will allow this beam to stress freely, then all the molecules are moving naturally. No one is disturbing each other. Because they want to expand. Because they have got some heat energy. So they want to be more natural. So that's why they want some gap. So no stress will develop if the expansion is happening freely. But stress will develop for sure if you will stop this expansion. Then what will happen? These molecules will try to expand, but someone is stopping them. If you are stopping, then definitely stress will come into picture. Then what kind of stress will develop here? Longitudinal stress will develop here. Same sigma will develop here. So once you got strain, multiply that strain with capital E value and you will be getting that thing. So this is E is multiplied with strain. You will be getting this thing, sigma, because of thermal effect. Now, trick. In GATE exam, what will they do? They will make like this. This is like some point, fixed point. Here you have beam. And suppose here they will put a wall, another wall. And they will say that this gap is, consider for example 0.2, and they are heating. So in this heating, they will say that temperature is changed by some 50 degree. Change in temperature, directly I am saying change in temperature, I am not saying beginning and final, only change I am saying. they will say that initial length was something whatever, 20 something whatever, some rough idea I'm talking. And alpha value also, I don't remember right value, so consider some value. So based on all these three values, suppose you are getting your del L value. Suppose you got, now we'll consider three case. Suppose I got my del L just 0.1. Suppose I got my del L 0.2 exactly. Suppose I got my del L 0.4. Now imagine, this del L is because of thermal expansion. So if thermal expansion is only 0.1, only 0.1, so this guy will expand only this much. It means what? This wall did not disturb any kind of expansion. So you will treat this as free expansion. In case of free expansion, change in length is there. Original length is also there. So del L by L is also there. Means strain is definitely there. But no stress. Why no stress? Because you did not stop the expansion. That's why they expanded freely, because they wanted to expand only 0.1 and you have sufficient gap to expand 0.1. Now imagine, by using this question, you are getting your del L exactly at 0.2. So that's again no expansion. Why? Again no stress, because exactly at 0.2 expansion will stop. So again this wall will not stop the expansion. Consider this as 0.5. Now the third case, when expansion will happen for 0.5, but the gap is only for 0.2. So first thing, you find out del L value by using alpha, L, del T, and after solving them, you got del L is equal to 0.5, but you saw that only 0.2 gap is available for expansion. What about 0.3? Because we are able to expand only 0.2 freely, then remaining 0.3, where will I go to expand? So you cannot go for expansion for 0.3, because here you have wall. So strain will also develop only for how much change you have done in the length. And stress will develop how much was disturbance. So 0.3 is your problem. Because of this 0.3, you can't adjust this. Somewhere you will bear. So you will bear inside the body. So stress will develop, thermal stress will develop when you are not able to expand by some amount. So that amount will disturb you. Okay. So sometimes sometimes they can fix the beam properly between two walls. Like this. And then they will heat. And then they will ask, whether stress will be how much, strain will be how much. So in that case, whatever change in length you will find by formula, anything you can't expand. So all the length will disturb you for stress. Okay. So this is what about thermal stress and thermal strain. Yes. Yes, yes. Okay, good question. Okay, now see. Your question is, earlier length was, suppose earlier length was only 2. Now increment is 0.2 and, wall is here. And this 0.3 we could not expand. So you are asking, while finding the stress, should we take this 2 or this 2.2, right? You are asking this? Okay, so see dear, this stress is coming because of this 0.3 disturbance. So because of this 0.3, how much stress you will be achieving? So this 0.3 will decide how much strain would have come because of this 0.3. How much strain would have come? So this 0.3 is the change in length which is not happening with respect to original length 2. So first you find out strain. That strain you multiply by E. That will be giving you stress. I hope I am clear. Tirthraj? हाँ यस यस इनिशियल, यस यस इनिशियल लेंथ। हाँ, नो आई एम नॉट गेटिंग यू नाउ, आई एम नॉट गेटिंग यू। नो विद दैट टाइम विल बी हैविंग डिफरेंट स्ट्रेस। हाँ ओके, सी बिकॉज बिकॉज मॉलिक्यूल्स आर ऑलरेडी दे हैव एक्सपैंडेड फॉर सम 0.2, सो दैट मच पार्ट वी डोंट हैव टू कंसिडर। वी हैव टू कंसिडर फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग वॉट वॉज देयर सिचुएशन, दैट्स वाई वी आर कंसिडरिंग बिगिनिंग लेंथ एज अवर ओरिजिनल लेंथ। सो वेन वी टॉक अबाउट मॉलिकुलर लेवल देन समवॉट स्टोरी विल बी क्लियर। ओके, सो वी आर एबल टू डू थर्मल स्ट्रेस नाउ, थर्मल स्ट्रेस डन। नाउ फ्यू थिंग्स